Rahul Iswar, that's an interesting point that Renuka Narayan is making, that this is not religious attachment, it's actually the politics of identity. It's not a spiritual quest, it's a political war cry. When you defend Sabarimala and the shrine of Sabarimala with the kind of passion that you do, are you actually undertaking a spiritual defense or are you taking a political position?
Swami Sharanam Sagarika ji, there are three points. One, the modern English North Indian media always tries to defame and destroy religion. There are some unfortunate incidents that happen. We condemn them. We are sad for the person who was killed. But that doesn't mean the whole religion, all religions are bad. Second point, I come from a tradition where our Lord Ayyappa had consecrated a mosque for Babar or Wavar, as we call him, 1,000 years ago. Now it might be appeasement, political appeasement. But I come from a tradition which respect and worshipped a Muslim as a god or as equal to God 1,000 years ago. That's the second point. Mm-hmm. The third point, sensitivity is a very important issue. It has become pseudo-intellectual, pseudo-modern and pseudo-liberal to say that whatever religion is doing is bad, all religions are bad or all religions are alike or all religion promote violence. What about politics? More people are killed in politics. And the very important point is, same thing about Taslima Nasreen and Mr. M.F. Hussain. These cheap, controversy-seeking, publicity-seeking people, often religious sentiments, mm-hmm. provoke people into action and suddenly the whole modern media comes up, defends them.
Sensitivity. Okay, Renuka Narayan, that's a good point to
village,
put
you
to you.
You should be sensitive.
Are the modern armies...
Rahul.
Right.
Sorry, what are you saying?
Are the modern proponents of this kind of aggressive religion, basically is the enemy the pseudo-intellectual, the pseudo-liberal, the so-called anti-religious forces? Is that the battle they're fighting?
I think Rahul, as usual, is making an extreme statement. I don't think the North Indian media is desensitized to religion. I think a lot of people know their stuff out here. And second of all, I don't think it's just pseudo-intellectuals, quote-unquote, who are against everything. Nobody's saying all religion is bad. People do try and look at issues case to case. Sure, we need to understand more and know the texture and nuances of things better. Mm-hmm. But I think he's going way over the top right now.
Okay, that's a good point to take a break on. In fact, that other side of young